हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर मिलन मी पटेल फ्रॉम महात्मा गांधी इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्निकल एजुकेशन एंड रिसर्च सेंटर नवसारी। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस चैप्टर नंबर 1 इंडक्शन मशीन्स फ्रॉम द सब्जेक्ट इलेक्ट्रिकल मशीन 2 हैविंग अ सब्जेक्ट कोड 315-0910 ऑफ द सेमेस्टर 5th BE इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट। सो टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द डबल केज इंडक्शन मशीन रोटर, डबल केज इंडक्शन मोटर रोटर एंड क्राउलिंग एंड कॉगिंग इफेक्ट इन इंडक्शन मशीन। सो दिस बोथ द टॉपिक्स आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट विथ पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू ऑफ द GTU एग्जामिनेशन। सो नाउ फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल डिस्कस द डबल केज इंडक्शन मोटर, डबल केज इंडक्शन मोटर। So one of the advantage of the slip ring motor is that the resistance may be inserted in the rotor circuit to obtain the high starting torque as low starting current, and they cut out to obtain the optimum running conditions. We know that in slip ring type induction motor we can connect external rotor resistance in the rotor circuit to improve the starting torque by the equation torque is directly proportional to the E2I2 cos phi 2. By simple adding the rotor resistance, we will improve our power factor, and due to this increase in the power factor, simply our torque, starting torque will be improved. So however, the such procedure cannot be adapted for the squirrel cage motor because its cage is permanently short circuited. So in order to provide high starting torque at low starting current, double cage type construction is used. And we all know that in squirrel cage induction machine there is no chance of any added resistance in the rotor circuit because we all know about the they are short circuited at end by the end rings. So we have to use double cage type construction in the squirrel cage machine. So let's start with the construction of the double cage induction motor. So as the name suggests, the rotor of this motor has two squirrel cage windings located one above and another one is the below the first winding. So it is called inner winding and outer winding, or inner cage or outer cage. So this type of rotor is made up of two cages. First one is outer cage, second one is the inner cage. So the outer winding consists of bars of a smaller cross section area. Outer bar having a smaller cross section area and short circuited by the end rings. Therefore, the resistance of this winding is high. We know the equation of the resistance R is equal to rho L by A, where we can simply see that R is inversely proportional to the area. So outer cage has small cross section area means higher the resistance, because we know that R is inversely proportional to the cross section. Smaller the cross section, higher the resistance. Since the outer winding has relatively open slots and poorer flux path around its bars, it has a low inductance. Because outer winding has relatively open slots, because in outer side the bars are placed in the open slots comparatively to the inner cage, and poorer flux path due to the open slot. So it has a low inductance. So the outer winding has हाई रेजिस्टेंस लो इंडक्शन इंडक्टेंस, सो दिस आउटर वाइंडिंग और आउटर केज हैज हाई रेजिस्टेंस एंड लो इंडक्टेंस, दस द रेजिस्टेंस ऑफ द आउटर स्पिरल केज वाइंडिंग इज हाई एंड इंडक्टेंस इज लो. सो नाउ लेट्स डिस्कस द इनर वाइंडिंग. सो इनर वाइंडिंग कंसिस्ट ऑफ बार ग्रेटर क्रॉस सेक्शन शॉर्ट सर्किटेड बाई द एंड रिंग्स. सो हियर ग्रेटर द क्रॉस सेक्शन लोअर द वाइंडिंग रेजिस्टेंस, लोअर द वाइंडिंग रेजिस्टेंस बिकॉज वी नो दैट द आर इज इक्वल टू रो एल बाई ए. सो आर इज इनवर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल टू द एरिया. सिंस द बार्स ऑफ द इनर वाइंडिंग्स आर थोरली बरीड इन द आयन, थोरली बरीड इन द आयन, इट हैज अ हाई इंडक्टेंस, इट हैज अ हाई इंडक्टेंस. दस द रेजिस्टेंस ऑफ द इनर स्पिरल केज वाइंडिंग इज लो एंड द इंडक्टेंस इज हाई. सो दिस इज द बेसिक कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ द डबल केज इंडक्ट डबल केज स्क्विरल केज रोटर. नाउ दिस इज द ग्राफिकल रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ द डबल केज टाइप रोटर. सो दिस इज द आउटर केज, दिस इज द आउटर केज एंड दिस इज द इनर केज. सो वी कैन सिंपली सी दैट दिस इज द आउटर केज हैविंग अ स्मॉल क्रॉस सेक्शन एरिया कंपेरेटिवली इनर केज बार्स. सो दिस आउटर केज हैज लार्ज रेजिस्टेंस इंडक्टेंस एंड इनर केज हैज लो रेजिस्टेंस हाई इंडक्टेंस. सो दिस इज द टॉप बार एंड दिस इज द बॉटम बार, दिस इज द कोर. सो दिस इज बरीड थरली बरीड इन द इनर कोर and this is the open slot outer cage bar. So now let's see the working for the double cage type rotor. When a rotating magnetic field sweeps across the two windings, equal EMFs are induced in each. At starting, the rotor frequency is same as that of the line, means 50 hertz, making the reactance of the lower winding much higher than that the upper winding. So at starting, the rotor frequency is the same as that of the frequency 50 hertz, making the reactance of the lower winding much higher than that of the upper winding. So at starting, the impedance or reactance of the inner windings are higher than the outer winding. That's why at starting all the maximum current will flow from the outer cage. Maximum current will be flow from the outer cage. Because of the reactance of the lower winding, nearly all the rotor currents flows into the high resistance outer cage. So all the current flow through the high resistance outer cage. This provides the good starting characteristics of the high resistance cage winding, and due to the high resistance, the high starting torque will be developed in this type of rotor. Thus, the outer winding gives a high starting torque at low starting current, and due to the high resistance, low starting current will flow from the outer winding. As the motor accelerates, the rotor frequency decreases. We all know that the rotor frequency f dash is given by s into f, and as the speed increases, the value of slip decreases, and due to this decrease of the slip, the rotor frequency also decreases, and due to the decrease of the rotor frequency, the reactance of the rotor's inner cage, the reactance of the inner cage decreases, and the inner cage has also low resistance. So impedance of the inner cage decreases at the rated speed, and due to maximum current will be flow through the inner cage during the running condition. So the outer cage is only used for the starting purpose, and for running purpose, the inner cage is used. The inner cage is used only for the running purpose. And the rotor frequency at the running is low as low 2 to 3 hertz, and all the rotor current flows in the low resistance inner cage winding. This result in the good operating efficiency and the speed. Now this is the graphical representation of the full load torque versus the percentage slip. Percentage full load of the per versus the percentage slip. One graph is, this is the standard cage rotor. This is the standard cage rotor, means single cage squirrel cage rotor. And this graph is for the double cage type squirrel cage rotor. So we can simply see that the starting torque is very good in the double cage type. We can simply see that this is the maximum starting torque, and this is the maximum starting torque for the standard squirrel cage type rotor. So this is the main advantage of the double cage type squirrel cage rotor. So the low starting torque disadvantage will be overcome by using the double cage type of the squirrel cage. Now, cogging and crawling effect in induction motor. Cogging and crawling effect on the induction motor. So first of all, discuss the crawling of induction motor. Crawling of induction motor. So sometimes the squirrel cage induction motors exhibits a tendency to run very slow speed, as low as the 1/7 of the synchronous speed, means 7th 1 by 7 of the synchronous speed NS. So this phenomena is called as crawling of an induction motor. So this phenomena of running very low speed of induction motor is called crawling effect. So this action is due to the fact this action is due to the fact that flux wave produced by a stator winding is not purely sine wave. Instead, it is a complex wave consisting of a fundamental wave and odd harmonics like third harmonic, fifth harmonic and seventh harmonic. The fundamental wave resolves synchronously at synchronous speed ns, whereas the third, fifth, seventh harmonic may rotate in forward or backward direction at ns by 3, ns by 5, ns by 7 speed respectively. Hence, harmonic torques are also developed in addition with the fundamental torque. So due to this third harmonic, fifth harmonic, seventh harmonic, etc., etc., the different torque will produce. Different torque will produce due to the harmonic currents, and due to this harmonic currents, the synchronous speed will be rotate in the forward backward direction at the speed of ns by 3, ns by 5, ns by 7. Hence the harmonic torque are also developed in addition with the fundamental torque. So the harmonic torque are also developed in addition with the fundamental torque. So harmonic torque will be produced in addition with the fundamental torque in the induction motor due to the harmonic current of the third harmonic, fifth harmonic and the seventh harmonic. So third harmonic are absent in balanced three-phase system. Third harmonics are absent in the balanced three-phase system. Hence, the third harmonic do not produce a rotating field and a torque in the three-phase balance system. The total motor torque now consists of three components. First one is the fundamental torque with the synchronous speed ns, then fifth harmonic torque with the synchronous speed ns by 5, एंड द सेवंथ हार्मोनिक टॉर्क विद द सिंक्रोनस स्पीड ns/3 ns/7. नाउ द फिफ्थ हार्मोनिक करंट विल हैव द फेज डिफरेंस. सो द टॉर्क मे बी इन फॉरवर्ड डायरेक्शन और बैकवर्ड डायरेक्शन डिपेंड ऑन द नंबर ऑफ हार्मोनिक. सो नाउ डिस्कस अबाउट द फिफ्थ हार्मोनिक. फिफ्थ हार्मोनिक करंट विल हैव द फेज डिफरेंस ऑफ, वी ऑल नो दैट द फिफ्थ हार्मोनिक करंट हैव अ फेज डिफरेंस 5 × 120. 5 × 120 इज इक्वल टू 600 डिग्री. And 600 degree is simply given by 2 into 360 means 720 minus 120 minus 120. So the phase difference is minus 120. Phase difference is minus 120. Hence resolving the speed setups will be the reverse direction with the ns by 5. So this ns by 5 is in reverse direction due to the this minus 120 phase difference. The small amount of fifth harmonic torque produces the braking action and can be neglected. Can be used for the braking action and can be neglected. Now discuss the seventh harmonic current. So seventh harmonic current's phase difference is given by 7 × 120 and it is given by 840 degree. So it is simply given by 2 × 360 means 720 plus 120. So its phase difference is plus 120 degree. Hence they will set up the rotating field in the forward direction with the synchronous speed ns/7. So seventh harmonic will set up the forward direction of the speed magnetic rotating magnetic field at the synchronous speed of ns/7. If we neglect all the higher harmonics, the resultant torque will be equal to sum of the fundamental torque and the seventh harmonic torque. Fundamental torque and the seventh harmonic torque. Seventh harmonic torque reaches its maximum positive value just before the 1/7 of ns. Just before the 1/7 of the ns. If the mechanical load on the shaft involves a constant load torque, the torque developed by the motor may fall below this load torque. So in this case, motor will not accelerate up to its normal speed, but it will run at a speed which is nearly equal to the 1/7 of its normal speed. So this is the crawling effect. So we can simply examine the crawling effect in this graph. So this is the torque versus speed and slip graph. Torque versus, this is the speed 0 to 1, this is the slip 1 to 0, this is the torque axis. So this is the starting torque. Gradually torque will be increased due to the seventh harmonic, again reduction of the torque. So this is the crawling speed. This is the crawling speed at where the torque is at below the constant torque line. This is the constant torque line and some torque is below this constant torque line. That's why this is the crawling speed. This is called crawling speed. This is the stable region. This is now unstable region. And again, this is the stable region. We can simply see that this is the stable region, like over there this portion is stable. Again, this is the unstable and this is the stable region for the induction motor, and this is the crawling effect. So simply we can see that this is the negative torque. I hope you understood this. Now last topic, cogging or magnetic locking or another name is teeth locking of induction motor. So three name for this effect: cogging effect, magnetic locking effect, teeth locking effect. Yes. So sometimes the rotors of squirrel cage induction motor refuses to start at all, particularly If the supply voltage is low, sometime the rotor of the squirrel cage induction motor refuses to start at all, particularly if the supply voltage is low. This happens especially when the number of rotor teeth is equal to number of stator teeth. So this will happens if the rotor teeth is equal to the stator teeth. Because of the magnetic locking between the stator teeth and the rotor teeth, when the rotor teeth and the stator teeth face each other, the reluctance of the magnetic path is minimum. That's why the rotor tends to remain fixed. So this phenomena is called cogging of magnetic locking of induction motor. So this is the simple cogging in which the motor refuses to start due to the number of teeth of the stator is equal to number of teeth of the rotor, and phases of the teeth of the rotor and the phases of the teeth of the stator is same, then the low magnetic path will be created, and this is the main reason behind the fogging in the induction motor. I hope you understand today's video lecture.